Yo, what is up? What is going on, everybody? Shout out to all the people on YouTube and on Twitter. We're about to get started here in a minute. Yo, what is up? What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. Welcome back to another stream. Let me lift up my chair a bit. Welcome back to another stream. I am tired. I'm exhausted, guys. I'm exhausted. Tired. That's what I will start off and say. I'm happy to all 401 of you that are subscribed to Lubinto LLC. Thank you. Thank you. Everybody's doing well. We did not stream last week, and for very good reason. Had a lot of work to catch up on, and was busy kind of doing some other things in the background, as I normally do when it comes to Lubinto. Do a lot of background stuff. Had to do a lot of administrative work. You guys are seeing me right now share this to you live. Let me actually Let's get out of that. I actually got to share this to Twitter because I forgot about sharing it to Twitter. But yeah. Want to make sure that no, go back. Actually, we just want to make sure that everybody's doing good. Because I know I am. I know I'm doing great. Yeah, there was a lot. What's going on? Hey, what's going on, Karuto? See you there. Love to have you here, as always. Glad you could make it. Hello, mother. Hello. Glad everybody here could make it. We're going to be sharing this really quick on Twitter, and then we're going to get started. We're just going to be drawing some Penguin Boy Chapter 2 today. We're not going to be doing anything extensive. We're not going to be doing anything crazy. I just want to say a shout out, a big, big, big shout out to the homie, G-Storm. Shout out to G-Storm. He was on live on TikTok the other day, shouting me out, telling people to go subscribe and go check me out. I would say the same for him. Go check out G-Storm when you get a chance. Very talented individual working on multiple titles. Very talented individual. His TikTok is loaded with information about his stories and other things. Sorry, give me 1 second. I still have to do this. I'm gonna play some music while we're here. That way nobody's like, what's going on? Should I play Goodnight? You know what? We're gonna play this one. Not that one. I meant this one. I lied. We're playing this one. Nope, not that one. I lied. We're playing this one. Third time's a charm. Yeah, there we go. This one. This one's a nice one. A little lo-fi stuff. Could I possibly get my portrait? No portrait for you. No portrait. Yo, what's going on, D-Rot? What is up? We're just streaming some stuff. Streaming some beats that I made. Streaming some things that I got going on. We're not streaming any beats that I made. I'm just joking. But yeah. I'm just kind of going through. I still have to post this. I just enjoy the chat so much. We haven't even really started. All right, to all my Twitter people, I am posting the actual YouTube link in the description. That way it's there. If you want to go check it out and you want to subscribe to the channel, because we're always coming back, you might as well get notified at least, you know? So yeah. My YouTube chat won't load, so I'll just watch there on Facebook. 100%. Wait, we didn't stream last week. We did not stream last Friday. No. We did not stream last Friday. We streamed Tuesday, though. We did stream Tuesday. But yeah. Everybody, look. All I'm going to say is this. As usual, before we start deep diving into stuff, visit loombento.net. As you go on the page the first time, you'll always be able to see it says get the latest manga and news right there. You can either sign up for the email list or you can hit the X if you're already signed up. You can actually see who we are. You can read our recent contest entries, soar through our manga, or explore our light novels. Going down, you'll see The Paladin's Tale, Winter and a Raven, the story that I just released this month. I actually released it earlier. I think I released it on the 10th or the 9th because we hit 400 subscribers. 400 subscribers! We're now at 401. If you head on down here to the manga section, you'll see the four manga that we currently have. One's a one-shot, two are, these two over here, but Penguin Boy's the newest one. Same thing with the light novels. We have A Paladin's Tale and Polymon Fur. And just going from there, you'll be able to sign up for our newsletter again, read our information, and see the latest contest entries. So yeah. That's it on that part. So be sure if you want to read our stories to head over to loombento.net and check those out now. Anyway, on to the topics, on to the drawing. We are live. Currently in the middle of drawing a panel. So I'll share that here. Currently in the middle of drawing this panel right here. Yes, Penguin Boy, let me get my chair. Yes, sir. Grab that chair. Grab some popcorn. Grab some food. We're going to be here for at least an hour and a half. So I mainly want to say, you know, this, going back to the whole thing when it comes to people being able to share other people's content. Like, sharing stuff is caring, I feel like. Especially if it's good stuff. You know, we've all shared things that we thought were going to be good and they turned out to be, like, pretty crap. But I still think sharing content is better overall than anything else. I love you too, Mom. Be safe out here in them streets. Thank you for popping in, by the way, over here on the old Facebook. Anyway, but yeah, you know, sharing of content. I think a lot of people don't know how to share other people's content, not because they don't want to, but because they've never really cared to. It's not hard to get in other people's content. It's hard to get into other people's stories, I feel like. I think it's just the story aspect of it. You know? I mean, what do you think? Okay, yeah. Giving you flashes of it, you know, flashes of it. Somebody said they tried they were trying to draw a picture of Penguin Boy, but they didn't quite understand like how his bangs were. And I told them, I was like, just draw them however you want, man. Fan art doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be fan art. That's what I'm drawing, so I gotta do this. You know what's crazy? Like, drawing this stuff like how I am now, like, this is what it comes from. Doing rough drafts, like, can you imagine trying to draw something from this? Like, just be real with me for a sec. Like, Karuto, D-Rock, like, do you guys imagine you could draw something from this? Because to most people, it probably just looks like fucking scribbles. But it's not. And I'm able to take something like this and be like, okay, this is exactly what I'm imagining this. Like, this looks like a way better rendition of, like, you can understand, okay, these guys are on the ground. It looks like people are helping them up. It's not always the case, though. So, yeah. I'm really not doing anything like crazy too. I'm just kind of foreshadowing or foreshortening things. So what I mean by that is I'm drawing, instead of drawing a character that's like, it's like this. I'm just stacking all those elements on top of each other. And then I do that to kind of show volume. It's the exact same lines if I went across, but it's just different. I have a problem sharing anything as long as I like it. I will preach about it every time I can. Yeah. Yo, shout out to Karuto. He did an excellent video. Very funny. He had some funny bits in it. Did a review of Penguin Boy. I was pretty happy about it. I was like, hey, we're famous. We're getting reviewed. Give this person a mohawk. This is a bird. See, it's a beak. This is a panda bear. So there's this little mat here. Blankets on the ground. Oops, went to the wrong one. Yeah. G Sermon said a lot of interesting things on his video. He said, you know, you got to spoil some of it to get people interested. And I wholeheartedly believe that. I wholeheartedly believe that. I believe that, you know, it's to some degree, you know, we're not like the big guys, and nor do we want to be. Facebook is ahead of YouTube. Absolutely no from my end. Facebook is always going to be ahead of YouTube. I feel like Facebook is always going to be ahead of YouTube just because, like, Facebook doesn't have as much, like, going on. Whereas YouTube, you got, like, hundreds of thousands of people, like, who are streaming from all different parts of the world. You know, I often wonder who all is streaming to Facebook. Because I stream to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. So I wonder if that also matters as well, like me splitting up the broadband like three different ways. Oh yeah. I'm gonna change the music again. We're gonna change it to the other one. Because I want to hear the other one now. I really like this one because, like, you could either rap to it or sing to it. I want to walk into another room, but now I feel like I'm missing something, and watching on my phone is whack. Hello, I can't comment on my TV. Yo, you know what's crazy? There's been people who have commented on their TV, but it's taken them so long to type in like a paragraph or a sentence that by the time they do it, I have no idea what they're talking about, which is really funny because you go to respond back. You're like, dog, when was I talking about this? Like, oh, you were talking about this and this and this. And it, like, happens. You're just like, I have no recollection of this.
if we weren't talking about it.
That's just the way it works, man. Oh, it's white. I don't want it to be white. I need it to be black. That way I can actually draw it. Okay. I'm definitely going to make some more music for the YouTube channel. What are we thinking? You guys want something more lo-fi? Something more lo-fi than the two tracks that I have? Because I think this is pretty lo-fi. Lo-fi-ish. What I made. Get these ends down here, Dirk. So I was reading a book today. Does anybody know of, I think it's The Creative Act by Rick Rubin. D-Rock, I know you might know it, but I was reading that. I finally finished that book for the second time, and it's really good about like creativity and just, and it's great about the whole thing. You know, I bought the audiobook and then I ended up buying the physical book on my phone, and I ended up reading and listening to the audiobook at the same time. So it was like, yeah, it's really good. If you haven't read The Creative Act, it can apply to anything you do creatively. It doesn't just have to be music. I need more Alba D Island Boy. His name just like me for real. Or he's just like me for real. Which is actually a funny joke. Somebody actually, I think Carlton, were you the one that mentioned like Albert the Island Boy? Which was really funny to me because I was like, I didn't mean for it to come out that way, but it did. Which I guess just works. But yeah, no, The Creative Act is a great book. I put a couple of my friends onto it because, you know, they would always think one way creatively. And I was like, dog, like you got to start thinking outside the box when it comes to being creative. I mean, there's so many ways and routes to do things, you know? I think at this point, 7. Okay, it's this. But there's so many different ways and routes to like actually be creative. I always kind of tell people, or I've been telling people a lot more now, like, yo, you know, be open to collaboration, be open to these things. Because at some point I wasn't super open to, like, I was open to collaboration, but it wasn't as much as I am now. You know, it wasn't as much as I am now, and like my understanding of working with others is so different than the way it used to be. Don't get me wrong, you can't work with everybody. There's a lot of people who are not worth working with. And that's it. Yo, Mrs. H in the chat. It is Penguin time. She is right. Penguin Baby. Remember, everybody. If I remember correct, I think Yoshi did a drawing to this. This title, Penguin Baby. I think Yoshi did a title to that. So yeah, there's that. You cut mine up. You can just set it like on the counter over here. Just set it on the table over here. I have food for me, but I cannot eat it yet. We still have about an hour left before I'm able to do anything. But yeah, I got a lot of work to do. Working on multiple things. Some people in the chat might know what I'm working on, but I can't relay everything yet until it's time. So yeah. But tell me, I mean, how do you guys feel about this song? Is it too slow? You guys want something more upbeat in the future? Let me know what kind of music you want. I can make it. I can make it happen. You want some straight up hip hop? You want some house music? I don't know if I can make house music. I only was able to make like a couple different house tracks. They are really hard to make. Like, you got to really know frequency and sound to, like, really know what you're doing when it comes to making that type of music. But now we're on the line art phase. Mrs. H, how are you doing tonight? Yo, to everybody that is watching right now, be sure to give this video a like or a thumbs up. And if you are over on Twitter, if you are over on Facebook, be sure to head over to the YouTube. YouTube should be in the link or the description below. It should be in the comment section. You're over on Twitter. D-Rock says, I like it for the intro slash outro when you're talking more, then maybe something more up-tempo when you might have more pauses in the talking. Yeah, you know, this is like, this is something I created because I wasn't sure how it would be when I was talking. And I think it's pretty nice. I almost said, I try to say nice and neat in the same thing. But it's pretty night. Saying nice and neat at the same time. I created a new word, night. I'm good. Ms. H says, I'm good, getting ready to start up my tablet and commence the doodle bug. She's going to be doodling on the doodle bug. Okay. I'm just working on some Penguin Boy, trying to get some stuff done. I got a lot to do this week. It's drawing some of these like anamorphic people are just so funny because you can really draw them however you want. And it's funny. Look at this guy. More music could probably put in a Lumento library. I don't know, man. Maybe there might be a Lumento library one day for music. Who knows? The world is our oyster, you know, we're able to kind of do anything. Let's see if I can play something else. Here we go. This is the one. This is the one a lot of people like. I didn't make this though, but I got permission to use this. This is the one a lot of people like when I play in between, like in between me talking, in between anything else. So I just keep this one rolling. Give me 1 second, everybody. 1 second. I must do something. Let me see. Hang on, Rock. I'm gonna send it to you right now. All right, there you go. All right, let's continue. Let's get back to this boom bap. So I have people asking me to make clothing that says they want that phrase on it. And I have some people asking me to make a shirt that says, let's get back to that boom bap. And I hear you. I'll just say I hear you for now. We have a lot of different things in the works. And clothing is definitely one of them. I've explained this already to some people. Clothing is definitely one of them. So, yeah. Oh, to those that were asking, I'm using Clip Studio Paint. We had a lot of people asking me that early on. Like, what program do I use to draw? I use Clip Studio Paint religiously. No ifs, ands, or buts. Really good program, and we were even sponsored by him for a minute. So yeah. You could be one animal, what would it be? If you could be one animal, what would it be? And why? Gonna try and find my coloring book so I can try to draw, so I can try to practice draw something out of it. Yeah, 100%. A cheetah. I feel like a cheetah's pretty dope. I would want to be some sort of like wolf or dog breed, I feel like. I would want to be like a wolf or a dog. Maybe that's just me though. So is anybody listening to music right now? I need to know this. Because I'm listening to music right now. And I don't mean like right now at this second. Obviously, we're all listening to music. I just meant like music as in like hip hop or anything like that. I'm like really big into this. There's this thing going on right now in hip hop where everybody's dissing Drake. And I really like where this is going. It's just really interesting. So you said a wolf. Okay. So we have Xerox says a cheetah. Mrs. H says a wolf. See, I still choose somewhere in the dog family. Maybe like a coyote. Maybe a fox or a wolf. I feel like I would choose a wolf as well. Thank you. 7, 5. So the top part. He has on black pants. So, something I wanted to ask you all. Oh, he said, can't wait for the next chapter. Yo, same. Cheetah, Fox, Eagle, big three to connect to your beef talk. Yeah, to connect to the beef talk. I already know, man. I'm excited to see what's going on. I was just really happy to see, like, just to talk on this music thing for a second. Then I want to talk about Webtoons and how they're, like, trying to apparently get rid of your rights or some shit. Oh, this panda? This guy here? Yeah, he's just chilling. He's just big chilling. But yeah, no, you know, just to talk about, you know, the whole Drake thing really quick, I think he's doing really good for himself in terms of music. I'm just really excited to see, like, what he comes up with a lot more. I know there's going to be, like, everybody's waiting for Kendrick to, like, say something. And I think, like, that's a really interesting thing as well. Is like everybody's just like, what's Kendrick about to say? What's he about to say? First off, we already know Kendrick's gonna come back with something cold. Like that's a given. But I'm more or less just excited to see, is anybody else gonna jump in on Drake's side? I feel like a lot of people are gonna come through and just kind of say some stuff and just be like. Some people are probably going to spaz out just because. But that's just my opinion. I don't know. I need him on some merch, okay? Yo, what is good? What is good, Ron? What is up? My man's like, huh? What's going on in here? Everything is going on in here. I was so way back from on the live, I didn't even realize it. Yeah, it was a panda, bro. It is a panda. But yeah. I'm just excited to see what happens next with that whole thing. And yeah, that's pretty much on that. Now, on the Webtoons, I think it's really interesting. You know, at first, I think Webtoons is going a route that a lot of people don't want it to go. But I mean, like, what else are you going to do with certain business practices? Now, not all businesses have to operate this way, because we don't. But a lot of businesses, they gain a lot more capital if they own an IP. And that's the way that, that's the route that Webtoons is going. You know, if you want to create a Webtoons original, well, you gotta get ready to have your IP taken away from you. Because that's how they roll now. So I mean, just imagine, you know, you're creating this comic or this manga that you've been wanting to make for a minute, and now your IP is gone. And it's going over something dumb as you doing that. I mean, they want to be able to steer it in the right direction. And so you have to ask yourself, do I want to have a successful series that I can control Or is it just you want to be somebody who's paid to kind of do some work? Because let's be real, most people aren't creating the next big thing by themselves. You need to have some sort of capital or some sort of person backing you in order to push your music or your content. You need to be submitting for events. You need to be submitting for things like competitions and whatnot. And that's going to be the thing that kind of pushes you into the next echelon of being a creative. You know, that's what makes you really good, is when you have a company backing you saying, hey, this person's work is tried and true. And that's for anything. It doesn't matter what industry you're in. Like, no matter what, at some point, a company's going to come to you and say, hey, give us X amount of control over what you're doing, and we will put you in front of millions of people. And you kind of just got to think to yourself, do I want to be in front of millions of people? Or do I want to be in front of millions of people and lose aspects or certain parts of my control of my work? Or do I want to retain that and be able to do exactly what I want to do? I think not everybody is meant to go independent. I think to be independent sometimes can be your downfall. I think to be independent is your downfall. And I think that's the biggest thing. So a lot of people right now are either leaving Webtoon or joining Webtoon because they don't care. I mean, people have been joining Webtoon because, you know, it's an easy platform to put out your story. But on top of that, you have to realize that, like, now the way they're doing contracts is just a little bit different. You know, they're doing them to where they're asking people, like, hey, you know, you have this interesting story. We would love to help you out and do this. But, you know, if we give you a Webtoon original, we want to be able to have, like, X amount of ownership of your stuff. I don't think, if I remember correctly, you don't lose full ownership. I think you lose, like, partial, or you lose, like, I think it's negotiable. But you got to remember that going into these things, you always want to negotiate. Like, look, guys, I want to come out of this. I know I won't come out all the way on top unless it's like I already have one series in the bag and I'm doing another series. It's kind of like, think about like Naruto, One Punch Man, One Piece. Like, when you have a series that's tried and true and it's bringing in all the revenue or the money or whatever, then, only then do you have a lot more bargaining power. Because a lot of people ain't going to want to hear it, especially if you're only getting big because they're promoting it. You know? And it's not like that's the only way for you to get big. You can have content that just, like, lands or that sticks. Yeah. The drama going on with Webtoon was settled out. Yeah, I just spoke about it. The whole drama right now is that they want creators, and I think that's one aspect of it. They want creators to, and if somebody knows more about it, please say it in the chat. The whole thing is just that, like, you want a creator to sign to your platform, and for free, of course, gain all this recognition, gain all this thing, have the freedom to create their story anyway. And just think about the most fucked up part about this, right? You created your story the way you wanted it to be, okay? You're the one who garnered all your fans. Webtoon had nothing to do with that. Maybe a staff picked your work one time out of the hundreds of other people they pick every month. And then you end up getting, like, oh, a staff recommendation. Oh, somebody's going to look at my stuff. But then out of nowhere, they approach you and say, hey, we want to take 45% of your story. We want to own that so that way we can tell you where to go and what to do with it. And then you got to think to yourself, okay, you built this up yourself. You built this up with your characters, with your story. You spent the long hours, the long nights. Now a company's going to come in and tell you exactly what to do. What do you want? You have to understand what you want. And to me, it's not a bad thing if a company does that and you agree to it. You just have to know and make sure that's what you want to do. Talking about stuff before you sign the papers is very important. Chances are you and the publisher can come to an agreement. 100%. You know, 100%. There's at no moment you cannot. If someone comes to you and asks about your story, if someone comes to you and says, "Hey, I want you to join," you have to understand that you hold a certain amount of power in the conversation. You hold a certain amount of weight because somebody came to you and said, "Hey, I want this story to be a part of what we do." So you have negotiating rights. That's all it is. Don't let them sweet talk you into thinking that you don't. That's what happens. Carlton Sanin says, facts. If you know you can't stand on your own feet, set yourself with a company and use that company as much as you can until you feel like you're ready to go your own way. People can be flexible. You just have to try and talk to them. I think both are a good thing. I think you should try and talk to your publisher. And then at the same time, just know that the story you're creating, it doesn't always have to be your best work. You could always come up with something else. You know, most people are like, "Oh my God, this is the one thing I have." And it's like, it's not. You have plenty of other ideas. I have plenty of ideas. I know everybody's not me. Kind of locking in with this right now. Let's see. Mrs. H says, I start with big publishers with lots of creative trying to sign on. No one wants to be taken advantage of, so they safeguard their interests. Creators have to do the same when going for big publishing deals. 100%. I think with the bigger publishing deals, the bigger publisher is always going to try and come out on top. So that means taking control of your story and doing what they know best. Run it through the market, run it through the mill until it's no longer liked. The one thing too, the reason why I'm not really like a creator of what I would say like traditional Western comics, I'm not really a huge fan of another person penning or writing my story. Not in the slightest. Like, not in the slightest. Now, if we were to collaborate and I was to at least draw it, then I would be okay with someone writing it, or vice versa. I could write it and someone else could draw it. But it's just that to me. Like, I don't care for those type of things. So I would much rather Like, I wouldn't want my IP to get bought by, like, let's say Marvel or DC, and then someone else draws it or does their interpretation of it. Because I know it's going to piss me off. I'm going to be like, this is dumb. This is stupid. Why would they do this? I can only imagine how they felt back in the day when they were like, yeah, we made it big. And then you realize that you know, the person who created Superman or the person who is drawing Superman or doing these things, I can't remember exactly which one it was. They died not as rich, not a rich person. They died poor because a company had bought their IP, especially back in the 60s or 50s or whatever. Bought their IP and was like, yeah, we know we're gonna turn this big. They made it big, and then they didn't see a single dime when they should have. That's the wackest shit you can do. I remember someone, my manager, told me, if you just go work for this business for 60 years without chasing your own goals, then you are fool. Yeah, 100%. I think so too. You go with small publishers, your approach can be different. Either way, you have to be aware that you need to give them something. Yeah. There has to be a pull and a push. Like, there was an individual I was talking to who wanted to join Lubinto, and the reason why they didn't join is because they wanted me to, like, pay their bills. They were like, yeah, you know, I got to be able to pay. I want to be able to do this and pay my bills. I said, dude, I'm not that big of a, like, I'm not running a big publisher. I can't pay you like $600 per page. I just can't do it. And, you know, I can't do that. And you can't get like 12 grand or 6 grand by the end of it. If I was paying people that, we would be doing some numbers. I guarantee there'd be people, some people who'd be like, you know what? I all of a sudden don't have a problem drawing from right to left. So, yeah. I want to fix this foot. Looks way better to me. Yeah, publishers can definitely be wary. With the whole Webtoon situation, I would just say look into it a little bit more. I looked into it for a couple of days. Excuse me, y'all. I looked into it for a couple of days and, found out what I found out. And it was pretty interesting. You know, reading all that. Actually, shout out to Pantheon. Pantheon had a whole video about this, and that was one of the videos I watched. So shout out to Pantheon for that, and I do appreciate that. Pantheon coming through. Yo, what up, Stefan Wings? I'm doing well. How about yourself? Yo, it's weird because it's telling me I don't have anybody on YouTube watching. Which is kind of weird to me. I feel like some people are there. Let me see. Oh, no. Only one person here. How sad. How sad. Yo, shout out to all 31 of you over on the Twitter. I appreciate you watching, stepping in. Appreciate you, Stefan Wings, for hopping in, checking us out. We are doing all good, though. He's drawing some of that Penguin Boy. Yeah, YouTube has to be bugging, man, because it says one person. It says I have 31 people in the chat in total, but it says all 31 of them are coming from Twitter. Yeah, and I'm looking at YouTube on my phone too, just to check, and it's saying the same thing. Only one person. YouTube is definitely bugging. Hey, you're applying some of those cross-section techniques. So you're talking about Kakeyami. You are applying some Kakeyami to your artwork. Let's get some of this background in there. The cheat code for this is just adding another layer. So what I'm doing is I'm drawing the background in another layer, and then I'm going to erase the parts that overlap, and then I'm going to combine the two layers. Because that's what heroes do. Cartel St. Ange says, me personally, it's understandable being careful joining a small company, but remember when that company gets its hype train, the serious that were there before the hype train will get promoted a lot. Yeah, because the fans, the people themselves, 100%. We all real over here on YouTube, believe me. I do believe you. Kakeyami? No. You spelled everything right, but the key part. So, Kake. So that's a Kakeyami. Kakeyami. You're all good. Just erase the background, and then I'm gonna combine them. All right, cool. Now it's on one. Just a little bit of texture. Same thing with this one. I'm just gonna give these little padded squares. Elon has gone nuts. If you made a new account and try to engage with anyone, you gotta pay. Huh? What? Naruto, stop lying. Boy, you know that's crazy. Big Crip Elon out here taxing people? He said, Big Crip Elon is out here taxing people. What a world we live in. I'm trying to make this art better for you guys, too. So I'm spending a lot more time on, like, a lot of the things that I'm doing. One of the biggest criticisms about Penguin Boy Chapter 1 from people was literally just the art. They were like, yo, it's a bit rough in areas. It's a bit this in areas. You know, it's this and this. And I'm like, oh, okay. So basically spruce up on my art. Basically take my time with it a lot more. I mean, that's what I decided to do anyway. I do know I was getting made fun of by a lot of comic fans. Because they were seeing my store and they were like, oh my God, it's so much white. It's hurting my eyes. And I was just sitting there laughing because that's what they were saying. And I just thought it was funny. They just couldn't handle the white. They were like, no, not the white. It needs color and deep shading to look like everything else. How dare it look like what it's supposed to look like? Well, I think it didn't help too, because he was calling it a comic. I'm not entirely sure. So when he was saying comic, I think they were like, oh, this comic is like totally undone. I honestly need to get into comics. That one piece of media I haven't diving into. Comics are really amazing. Like, if you start diving into the world of comics, they're really amazing. Hey, it's now showing me 6 people are on YouTube and 33 people are on Twitter. Yo, I don't know what I did to blow up on Twitter like this, but I appreciate y'all popping in, man. Once again, like, if you want to go see, if you want to go support, like, the actual YouTube channel, the link is in the description. Like, if you head down to the comment section, the link is in the comments. Yes, we hear our people. Carto. I meant to say I like that profile picture too. I really do like that that PFP. Hey, YouTube 6 making Penguina the manga for TGE Birds. Gotta make sure it's don't mind my bad spelling on live. I worry about spelling later on. I never worry about spelling in this one. Trying to get this dialogue down. Yeah, let me move this up. Thanks, it was fun redrawing it one day. Oh, the Any comics you really like lately? Thanks. It was fun redrawing it. One day I will draw my OC eating a burger. Yeah, you know, there is one comic I really enjoyed. Let me see if I can go find it. It was shared by Ken. Ken, who creates Air Rider. He shared to me this story because he said my story reminded him of it. And he thought both are like really good. Let me see. It's called The Witch's Throne, The Alchemist. It's on Tapas. If you search up The Witch's Throne, / The Alchemist, you should be able to find it. But that was a really fun one. I really enjoyed that one. And that's kind of a comic that I've really been enjoying reading. There's also novelist Nikki. She does her comic, which, why am I blanking on the name of this one? I feel so dumb. I know when I see it, I'm going to know exactly what it was. That's another comic I had to catch up on. She has a webcomic. No Strings. That's what it is. My brain was like, new something. No Strings. I've been reading her comic, No Strings, as well, which has been really good. Really good. All right. Well, it's about 1:16. We're going to leave it off at that. I've had this food behind me for longer than a little over an hour now, so it's cold. I'm guaranteeing that pizza's cold. So I got to go back and heat it up. I want to really dive into this, finish a bunch of pages, and I got some other work I got to do administrative-wise. But what I will say is thank you to everybody who came through, all 47 of you who are here right now. All 47 of you, I do appreciate you coming through. And yeah, remember to subscribe to the channel. We stream on Tuesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays now. Be sure to turn on those notifications. And yeah, like I said, subscribe to the channel. If you're not subscribed, then you're going to miss out. And you don't want to miss out on some of the greatest content. Which, you know, if anybody has any questions about drawing comics and manga, I'm the guy. But I really just want people to be able to come through, read stuff, and do stuff, and yes, and chill and hang out. But yeah, we're not going to play the outro for the regular video, but what we're going to do this time is I'm going to show the cover artwork for chapter 2 as we do the outro. So yeah. This is a cover page. So here's this. And yeah, we're going to switch it around and I'm going to head up out of here. We're going to start playing the other theme. Peace.
pants on, Wesso. Draw my pants off. Hopping book to book. Pin game got him shook. In the kitchen like a chef, you know I gotta cook. Every line I jot addicted, now I got him hooked. I can't let him pull me down, I just gotta push. West on West off, martial arts. Draw my ass off, martial arts. I don't box this, martial arts. I can't stop, I've come too far. West on West off, martial arts. Draw my ass off, martial arts. I don't box this, martial arts. I can't stop, I've come too far. They know I'm the one, but try me, catch a two-piece, yeah, yeah. Competition goofy, stretch them out like Luffy, yeah, yeah. I'm up, I'm chewing, spit you out like Loogie. You work till you gas, but I let it fuel me, yeah. Okay, wax off, martial arts. Draw my ass off, martial arts. I don't box this, martial arts. I can't stop, I've come too far. Like I'm shooting, I'm a star. Manga shooting up the charts. I've been running up the stakes. I've been lifting up the bar. Hopping book to book. Pin game got them shook. In the kitchen like a chef, you know I gotta cook. Every line I jot addicted, now I got them hooked. I can't let them pull me down, I just gotta push. West on West off, martial arts. Draw my ass off, martial arts. I don't box this, martial arts. I can't stop, I've come too far. West on West off, martial arts. Draw my ass off, martial arts. I don't box this, martial arts. I can't stop, I've come too far.